all, including the politicians, but also to people of other leaders and non-Christian religions. And we are sure that the Holy Father has recognized that these wonderful qualities of his in creating him a cardinal, and that too in such a very young age. As you know, our cardinal is the youngest cardinal in the whole Catholic Church, among I think 120 or 30 bishops, cardinals. And he has already took part on exercise his cardinalship already recently by electing a suitable pope. Because this pope is, of his nature, who is very sympathetic towards the poor, sympathetic to our people. And this last week, the Time magazine, the front page is the photo of the pope. And the title is a Pope of the People. Pope of the People, or rather People's Pope. And here we have a People's Cardinal. And so today, I am happy that we Franciscan brothers are giving him a helping hand in his Managara Catholic Church, in the Managara Catholic Church. And I am privileged to be associated with the Managara Church since about 45 years. And we can see and experience the tremendous growth of this church in various fields. His Eminence is a man of dreams and visions for the growth of this church. And therefore, this church has now several parishes and diverse pastoral and educational institutions, such as degree colleges, Maker Seminary, BN College, Engineering College, and even Law College. Are these not the results of his dreams and visions? His inter-religious collaboration and cooperation is another added feather. People of other religions look upon him as a recognized guru. And that is why even Hindu sannyasis and Muslim priests, or Muslim might be imams or something called this, they went to all the way from India to Rome to take part in the consistory ceremony that was held in Rome. And you must have observed that at the reception accorded to him in Thiruvananthapuram, he was flanked by two Hindu sannyasis and two imams. Indeed, a man for all seasons, a man for people, a man of God. There is a lot of biography. If I speak about his biography, actually, I went through last night the Google, Mamma Mia. Google is flooded with so many, so it can produce up maybe 80, 85 pages. So I thought this is my own maker. From my experience, I know him. I thought personal sharing probably better than this Google business. I have also hired a chat. He's very young, I said. He was born in 1959, very young. And then he was ordained a priest in 1986. I knew he was also a priest of Managara Church, came here to the early 70s and 80s, maybe 90s. And then he used to come here for celebrating the Mass on Sundays. And they were actually looking for a place. And I was privileged to give the place here for the Mass, and on Sundays I should come. And already my old some friends I met today also here. I'm happy to meet them. Because as I said, I was already working in the Managara Church as an active missionary. Therefore, I have the background. And I was only very happy to give the praise to give the to conduct the Sunday liturgy. And then he was made a bishop of Tiruvalla, Archbishop of Tiruvalla, and then Archbishop of Trivandrum, and created finally the major archbishop, Vasiodios, Natholika Bava. And then he was, as you all know, he was created a cardinal, and we are all very happy. And in the name of all of us, there will be a special welcome by Mr. Fernandez. Just on this occasion, I cut short, because if I go on speaking, I can speak one more hour. I know you get fed up with me. Therefore, I cut short and say, on this occasion, I pray that the good Lord may shower upon His Eminence blessings after blessings, that He may continue to instill greater inspiration in all people, that He may still do greater things for the glory of God and for the good of the people of all walks of life. A very hearty, cordial, affectionate welcome to you. The others will be welcomed by Mr. Fernandez.
Thank you, brother. Now to introduce our beloved Archbishop, Most Reverend Dr. Bernard Morris. He's already nodding his head, because if I start, he may only land up at dinner. Okay? So just a few points on him. I would like to say, ever since the Archbishop took up charge in Bangalore, he has motivated Bangalore. There's a lot of spiritual awakening in Bangalore. And not only in one area, but in every area of spirituality. If you look at him, he's young at heart. A very dynamic, spiritual, approachable person, making himself available even at the most busy and time and difficult schedules that he's got. To mention a few, he's the member of the Pontifical Health Commission of Rome and chairman of the Karnataka Regional Catholic Conference. He is also the president of the United Christian Forum for Human Rights and the chairman governing council, St. John's Medical College and Hospital. And there's a big list that comes under that, which I'm going to refrain from. His presence here itself reads volumes of his interest in his flock. Thank you, Your Grace, for being here. And we are very, very, very happy to have him here. Now, I will also would like Mr. Nigel Fernandez to escort, along with Mr. Baby Fernandez, the dignitaries, to light the lamp. Singing the hymn, we are gathering together unto him. Kindly rise.
We are gathering together unto Him. We are gathering together unto Him.
Holy Gospel according to St. John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things were made through Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the light was the light of all human beings. The true light that enlightens every man was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made through Him. And the Word became flesh and dwelt among us, full of grace and truth. We have beheld His glory, glory as of the only begotten Son from the Father. And from His fullness we have all received grace upon grace. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Almighty Father, bless the organizers of this Good News Book Expo 2013. Bless Mr. Nigel and all his co-workers and collaborators at Asian Training Corporation. Bless also Mr. David Joseph and his co-workers and collaborators at Mobile Booksellers. Bless this joint new initiative of theirs. These two persons and their organizations have always been committed to the growth of our church in India and the deepening of the intellectual formation in our seminaries and religious institutions. We have always benefited from their personal interest in getting us the best of theological and philosophical texts. Therefore, Lord, now we pray that this Good News Book Expo 2013 be a tremendous success, bringing glory to you and also leading these two organizations, ATC and Mobile, to further growth and expansion. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you, Father. You may please be seated. Now, all this while we had the introduction of the country and we began with a prayer. Now I formally invite Mr. Nigel Fernandez to welcome the guests and the gathering.
Your Eminence, Basilius Cardinal, famous Lutheran, Your Grace, Most Reverend Bernard Morris, Father Pankhurst, Director CRI, Reverend Fathers, Sisters, Brothers, and dear friends. Today, our hearts are filled with joy and thanksgiving. On one side, we have eminent dignitaries, our patrons, friends, and well-wishers, and on the other, we have the inauguration of the Good News Book Expo 2013. On behalf of all at Mobin Books and at ABC, I extend a warm welcome to each one of you. When we at Mobin Books and ABC count our many blessings we thank God specially for the blessing of giving us the opportunity of being a publisher and bookseller. The reason being, we get to constantly interact with men and women of God. The additional bonus is that they are highly knowledgeable as well as spiritual. Every interaction increases our spirituality and helps us grow. St. Francis de Sales, the patron of those who work in the mass media, said, "Knowledge is the eighth sacrament." Today, we have a gathering, 50 rectors and librarians from all over India, representing almost every state, have registered for the Good News Book Expo. Today we have about 30 of them. The others will join during the week. In addition, we have our own local patrons from institutions in Bangalore. So our joy is immense today that all of you are here. The role that a librarian plays is something important and extraordinary, and sometimes I feel that it is not adequately recognized. The books that librarians select and encourage people to read improves lives and changes lives. Last week, we had our annual blessing of our St. Mary's Town Book Center. A young priest who was ordained last year for the 18 Maslenas came for the blessing. And after the blessing, he told our staff that at the age of 8, he had bought the first Bible from ADC. And subsequently, he was coming regularly to ADC. And the spiritual books that he had read had helped nurture his vocation. In my 20 years as a publisher and bookseller, I have come across or heard or people have narrated to me hundreds of such testimonies where people have remained faithful to their vocation or been able to preach better sermons and thereby improve the lives of people and the spirituality of people. Lay people have said that they have understood Christ better or have been able to introduce Christ to people better or defend their faith better. Today, if you look at the lives of saints, you can see how books and reading have impacted almost every saint. This week, the church celebrates the feast of St. Ignatius of Loyola and St. Alphonsus Liguori. We know the impact that books had in their lives, as well as how they impacted the church with their writings. Earlier, St. Augustine or St. Anthony, who founded monasticism, we know what an impact they made to Christian civilization with their writings. In recent times, we know our blessed Kuriakos Elias Chavara, Thomas Merton, and Blessed John Henry Newman, who impacted the world with their writings. This year being the year of faith, Mobin Books and we at ADC felt that we should do something special for spreading good books, good literature, and improving faith. And this Good News Book Expo is a result of this. Today, first of all, we seek the continued presence of our Lord. Father Amrit Raj has already invited the Lord in our midst. We seek His blessings on this Good News Book Expo. It is my privilege to welcome His Eminence, Cardinal Clemus, here today. Brother Paz has already eloquently spoken about Cardinal Clemus. I would just restrain myself and like to say that we in Bangalore consider Cardinal Clemus to be a part of us because he has done his studies here, and by way of his ministry subsequently, he has endeared himself to so many people here, and he has so many fans and admirers here. Your Eminence, the fact that you have made time to be here today shows the importance you give to good literature. We are grateful to you and extend a very warm welcome to you. Your Grace, Most Reverend Bernard Morris, you had a hectic schedule today. Even then, you have made time to be with us here. We are extremely grateful to you and for your patronage to us over the years. What amazes us is how you keep going ahead in spite of all the challenges that you face, doing so much good for us, your people here in Bangalore and all over India. I always admire the constantly new initiatives that you take. Last week, the iftar gathering was, I felt, a concrete way of putting interreligious dialogue into practice. Similarly, the initiatives for migrant youth and so many things. We are proud to have you as Archbishop. We congratulate you on completing 9 years last year of your Archepiscopacy and extend a very warm welcome to you. Brother Pankras, Director of CRI, this is your house, we are here and you are actually the host, but as a formality, I extend a warm welcome to you. Along with you, I want to welcome the team, especially Brother Thomas, who has helped us so much, Brother Solomon, and Brother Gerard. To all of them, a warm welcome. To all the rectors, librarians who have come from far, we are honored by your presence. And even to the librarians from Bangalore here, we thank you for your constant patronage. By your presence here, you have shown us your love and affection, and we extend a warm welcome to each one of you. To all our well-wishers, friends, relatives, on behalf of Baby Joseph Mobin and all of us here at ABC, a very warm welcome to you. Thank you.
Thank you, Nigel, for those wonderful words of welcome. Okay, now the next part of the program is about our own book. Well, now I will invite Professor Cherian Alexander, a professor in English of St. Joseph's College of Arts and Science, to deliver us a talk on books. But just before he comes up to the dais, I would like to say something. A good book barely escapes competition. The question is, what book apart from the Bible have helped you the most? Anybody can answer that question? What book apart from the Bible have helped you the most? Yes?
Book of Life.
Wonderful. Anybody else?